This one corner morning,
ladies and gentlemen,
to the party show.
Here he is.
Here ready.
Freddie Starr.
You will tell me how many planes you have in your squadron. You will also tell me how many men are in your squadron. You will also tell me how many gallons of fuel you have left. You will also tell me how many people are in the British Isles still alive.
I wish you'd stop hitting me while I'm talking to you.
Ladies and gentlemen, myself and my penis now, ladies and gentlemen. We would like now... Shut up. ...to do an opera in C minor, ninth movement. Thank you. Thank you very much indeed. Thank you, sir. I fell off. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the opera. Thank you.
Today I went, today I went. I went to the butcher's. I went to the butcher. I went to the butcher's to buy some bacon. I I said to the lady behind the counter, do you sell bacon? She said, lean back. I said, do you sell any bacon? She says, we have not got any here, but we have some sausages. I said, give me 12 pounds of sausages. But I had no bags to put the sausages in. So I shoved the sausages down my shirt. Then I got on a bus to go home. Then this lady got on the bus and sat down opposite me. She looked at me. I looked at her. We simply did not have a care. Until a bus went over some cobbles. And all these sausages were shaking up and down. And one of these sausages flopped out. It was swinging to and fro, up and down, and about, up and down, up and down, up and down, up and down. So I got my penknife out. And cut it off. And she fainted. A bit further on, another sausage popped out. So I got my penknife out to cut that off. Then I fainted.
Yes, he's not going to misbehave tonight.
Rambo!
When I think of the people
that
I could have got on this show for this spot.
What spot?
This spot in this show. Can I have something to cover this flesh? It's putting me off. Is there anything I could... It's something... preferably a sack. Ah. Put that on. It's a smock. Put it on. And no, don't take those off. Just put that on and cover yourself. That... Put it on. Tell me when you're ready. Tell me when you're ready. Are you ready? Where are you? That... That's a little bit. Cover yourself up. No.
You make the poor sort of little thing. You really are.
Do you know who this belonged to, by the way?
One of the people
we could have had on the show tonight.
Who?
Boy George.
I love him.
Do you really want to hurt me?
This way. Just take a drink, Freddie. We are going to have a proper interview.
Fair enough.
Now, you've changed a lot. You've given up a lot of the bad habits, right?
Yes.
You don't do some of the dreadful things you used to do.
No.
And you're nowhere near as... Well, I don't know after that last little episode, but you don't seem to be as twitchy as you used to be.
Well, no, I've... It goes, just stems back, you know, that I've got more control now. I find out, working with people like that mad dog, people like yourself, I mean, I'm not as twitchy as I used to be.
Well, let me see. You're more of a family man these days. They're seeing a lot more of you.
Yes, they are. Too much.
Yeah.
Yes.
Have you taken the children to see any good movies lately?
I went to see this film.
That's a movie.
Pardon?
That is a movie.
What is?
A film.
Yes. And this movie was very, very, very good. Can I just get some things?
Where are you going?
Pardon?
Where are you going?
It's got nothing to do with you. It might be your show, but bloody don't tell me where to go, pal.
What's this got to do?
And in this film,
yeah,
right, there was Jack Palance. Jack Palance, yeah. Right? Richard Burton.
James Stewart.
And Chief Skidmore.
Who's that?
Chief Skidmore.
Chief Skidmore?
Yeah, you know when like a car goes across the ground and makes a mark? That's a Skidmore.
I'm a bit confused, Freddie.
So was he. Because his name was Bill Harry. And he came out and he went... And James Stewart said... James Stewart said, and Skidmore said, and just then. Jack Palance came in and he said, he said, Richard Burton came up and he was dying for a drink of orange juice and he went,
And James, you said, and this butler came in. No, he did. He came in like that. Because he had the right horn. The right horn. Look, excuse me, the right horn. And he said, it was Alan Ball.
Alan Ball?
Alan Ball, a footballer.
In this film?
Yeah, with the horn. He said,
hey, what's going on here then, in town then?
So Jack Palance said, scandal is all yours. And this Mexican fella came and said, gringo! Now, why I did that? Hey, gringo! Because every spaghetti western I've ever seen, the mouths are out of sync.
Hey, gringo!
So anyway, they shot him. I never did see the ending of that film.
Would you sing a song for us?
Sing you a song?
Yes. Ship.
Ship.
I'd like you to sing old... Is it old?
Old ship.
Ship.
Ship. When? Oh, it's got nothing to do with you. Keep your bloody mouth shut. Old ship.
I don't care what it's called anymore.
Oh, old ship. I'll sing you old ship.
Where's the microphone? I've put
it's here.
That's not a microphone.
Oh.
That's your right...
It's the horn.
That's
the Capricorn.
Do you want me to introduce you, or did you...
Oh, I want an introduction. You give Ursula and this one.
Yes.
Right? No, I rephrased that. I mean... All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is... What's your name again?
George Foreman.
Freddie... Here is Freddie Starr singing Old Ship. About a dog,
yeah,
isn't it?
It's about a dog, yeah.
When I was a lad, an old ship was a frog.
Eat it.
Over him,
frog.
In meadows we see.
It's a frog. Not a dog, the frog.
Just a boy and his frog.
Eat it, eat it.
We were both all fun. We grew up.
Eat it, eat it, eat it.
Together. Way. I remember the time.
Eat it, eat it, eat it, eat it.
At the old swimming hole. When I would have drowned.
Eat it, eat it,
beyond love.
Eat it, eat it.
But old Chevy has gone. Where the good dog is gone. All shepherds are wonderful
home. On a Saturday by the sea, you've got to see.
Found guilty of espionage against the Third Reich. The penalty for espionage is death. Have you any last request before sentence is carried out?
Look at it.
A blindfold?
Do with me what you will.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would now like to sing you a song. This song, when I sing it, please, I want no laughing. Because I'd like to be serious. So if I might be serious just for one moment. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, this song is about Vincent Van Gogh. He used to have a little van with Gogh on the side of it. And in his spare time, he would do some beautiful oil paintings in beautiful colors. But alas, he couldn't sell none of his paintings, and this made him very sad and depressed. Sometimes you would get even sadder. And that night, he went back to the only woman in his life he could ever trust. Yes, his mother. And that night he spoke to his mother very softly about his paintings. He said, Mother. Oh, Mother. For why can I sell none of my paintings? She said, the crap. With this, he went into a rage. And he cut off his left ear. His ear fell to the floor. It was a big ear. Shut up, love, and I've got to sing a song! Starry, starry night. Paint your palette blue and gray. Look out on the summer day. I knew you would. I had a hunch about it. Perhaps they listen now. Starry, starry light. Colors changing you, morning fields of amber grain, weathered faces lined in pain, are soothed beneath the artist's loving hand. For they could not love you till your love was true, and when no hope was left inside,
on that starry, starry night, you duped your life like lovers often do. But I could have told you, Vinny. I could have told you, Vinny.
This world was never meant for one as beautiful as you.
And last night in London, a brand new beauty competition took place. The first finals of the new Miss Mega Globe competition. We're very privileged because we have the first winner with us tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, will you welcome Miss Mega Globe 1986. Welcome you here, and of course the public would like. Probably not. what is your name?
My name is Frederick Starr.
You've got a very unusual figure. It's very lovely. What is your measurements?
38, 28, and have I got a surprise for you, Des?
You're certainly an unusual shape. Do you take anything for it?
Yes, Des. Anything.
Well, now, there must have been about 600 contestants in Miss Mega Globe.
Mm.
All different cultures.
Mm. Mm.
All different languages spoken.
Mm. Mm.
How did you manage to communicate with each other?
Quite simple. Just sign language.
Sign language?
Yes, for instance, if somebody wanted to borrow a powder puff, I'd say,
What does that mean?
Left tit behind.
Well, now, there are a lot of feminists looking in. It'll say, yes, typical.
Sorry?
A typical, eating the camera. A typical dumb blonde. What do you say to these feminists who say that all beauty contestants are just dumb blondes? What do you say?
Which camera are we on, please? Pick no, that one. What I say is this.
Carry on, please. Well, of your success in the... I assume you'll be in for a very busy year.
Yes, I'll be spending the first 6 months thanking the judges.
Well, is there anything, as Miss Mega Globe, anything you'd like to say to the viewers? Is there anything you'd like to say?
Yes, there's something I'd truly like to get off my chest. Yes, I'd like to get it off my chest once and for all. For I am what I am. I don't give a damn.
Wait, come on.
I am I.
Star of your show, Freddie Starr.
Tell me what I say. Well, tell me what I say. Tell me what I say. Tell me what I say right now. Tell me what I say. Hey, hey, hey. Well, I gotta know. Baby, I gotta know. Maybe I gotta know. Hey, hey. Shake that thing. Well, shake that thing. Ooh, shake that thing. Baby, shake that thing. Maybe shake that thing. Tell me what I say. Hey, hey. Oh, could I go bless?
Sit down. All right, Ben.
Shine on the wall, that's gonna let me blue. Kentucky will keep on shining. Shine on the water, that's gonna let me blue. I said blue moon, Kentucky will keep on shining. Shine on the wall, that's gonna let me blue. Well, it was on the moonlight
about that then, and as happens, because we have now on Top of the Pops, it falls off, Jim will fix it. Now, how's about that then, and as happens, because we have now on Top of the Pops, we have a blast from the past. And now, Pete, take that for a walk. Now, guys and gals, how's about that then, for Mr. Cliff Richard?
I got myself a quiet toy, sleeping, walking, living down. I got to do my best to please her, just cause she's a living doll. Got an open eye and that is why she's satisfied, that's all. Got the one on the board, living doll.
It's not unusual to be loved with a woman. Usual to go out in a bar. It happens every day.
All the girls go mad, ladies and gentlemen, for Engelbert Humperdinck. And I can't understand that, because his name spelled backwards is Nicoleg Tremblebum.
Please release me, let me go. Oh,
another day tomorrow. Cheers.
Welcome to Teddy Global's presentation of the match of the century between cup holders, the Kingstonians, and the renowned Showbiz 11. Of course, this had to be an all-ticket match, so we could be certain there would be no soccer violence on the terraces today. The kickoff is being decided in that warm, friendly atmosphere, so obvious here. A brief word of goodwill from Norman Wisdom, and play gets underway. Ray Charles playing as well as ever. You don't even see those people. Oh, what a great pass from Max Wall. This has got to bring Dracula into the game. Now he'll surely bring some bite into the play. The base is hotting up now as Tarzan swings into action. And I see Dracula is now leaping into the spirit of the game. And there's Elvis, always defending for the hit. The winner of this game is truly unbelievable. Tarzan makes a great back pass. Elvis shows us his great versatility. Or should I say Norman Wisdom? Norman takes a free kick and it looks as though the game's standing as defense is holding up half. The dazzling footwork of the show is an only best to be seen to be relieved. It must be a foul. Yes, it is. The referee awards a penalty to the Showbiz 11. Ray Charles is the obvious man to take it. This man has astounded goalkeepers all over the world.
Yeah, baby. Come on, baby. Let him take this penalty. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, baby. What you doing, man? I just kicked it. Ah, that's right. There we go. One more time. Yeah. Oh, no. Just there. Okay. All right, boy. There we go. Yeah.
Oh, what a goal! Give me the Kingstonian goalie little shot there. Quasimodo is going for a really hard tackle now, but the referee is also anxious to get into the game. I don't believe this. Where are the cameras? I think the score there is referee one, Quasimodo lost.
To introduce you to one of the world's great international singers, ladies and gentlemen, a gentleman who is, without a doubt, one of the world's leading sex symbols when it comes to song, a man I know you're going to enjoy, a man who's got talent, a man who's got style, a man who's got personality.
Thanks, Des.
It's not you.
That was good, that.
Fred.
That was very good, that. When you said that introduction, that was good, that was
Freddie,
good.
It's not you.
What is he?
That introduction's not for you, it's for him.
Who's him?
Him, one of the world's great entertainers.
I'm here.
Him!
Ooh.
Tom Jones, that's who.
It's not unusual to be loved by anyone.
When I think
Yes, think, go on.
When I think of all the great stars that queue up.
Ooh, go on. Ooh.
Queue up to get on this show.
Ooh.
People like Gene Pitney.
Gene Pitney.
Hey, Jeannie, Daddy, I had to wait to see that it won't be rough anymore. Cause something happened to me when I was driving him and he let this anymore. Cause I was homey. Baby, one day we find your heart.
I give you 10 seconds to get ready. I saw you do something on a Royal Command performance, and I must admit, it was funny. I give you 10 seconds. I'm going to count 10. You get 10 seconds to get ready to do Mick Jagger. And if you're back here, in 10 seconds, you can do it. I'm starting counting now. One, you got everything you need?
Fitted up with a new hearing aid.
Good morning.
How are you getting on with it?
Good morning.
I'm glad to hear it.
Good morning.
That'll be £250, please.
Get stuffed.
All right, come on, get dressed. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. What is it, Doctor?
I hardly know how to tell you this.
What is it?
I'm happy to tell you that you are pregnant.
That's impossible.
But there's no doubt you are preggers. Oh, you will go down in medical history, and so shall I. You will be famous, and so shall I. Yes, this is the end of the maternity ward as we know it. It's one giant birth for mankind, and mankind will be right behind you. You will be the talk of High Street.
I'll be the talk of our street. I'm not even married.
What's the trouble?
What?
What is the trouble?
I keep thinking I'm Napoleon.
No. You mean Nelson.
No, I am Nelson. I keep thinking I'm Napoleon.
Come in.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Today, I went to see a film. Yes. And in this film was great stars. Like, could you give us some cowboy music, please? James Stewart got off his horse and looked up at this vast mountain and said, the Indian said,
many buffalo pass this way.
Just then, riding round the mountain came the greatest swordsman in all the land, Zorro on his white horse.
Whoa! Move.
I, the greatest swordsman in all this land. Fight any man in the world.
Hey, Zorro.
For me?
Yes.
You wish to duel with the great Zorro?
Yes.
Okay. We fight.
Okay.
Man to man, fist to fist. Forget about the fist, the sword. Look. Thank you.